local, late breaking. This is WBAL TV 11 News tonight in HD. Speed cameras ticketing fast Maryland drivers, but a new high-tech tool is helping them avoid expensive fines. The I-Team investigates how the device is sending drivers speed camera alerts. Next.
This guy's moving pretty good. He's probably doing close to 45. And he's a local.
Joe Sigmund has been trying to get drivers to slow down for years. He lives on busy Schuster Road in back of a public school in Harford County. Farm country. The speed limit is 25 miles per hour, but he says few drivers obey it.
The sheriff's department puts their trailer out here on a regular basis. I've gone down there and watched it, and I've seen speeds as high as 60 miles an hour.
Joe says his street is a shortcut between routes 146 and 23, shaving about a mile off a driver's trip.
Definitely not 25, definitely not 35.
He's hoping Harford County will install speed cameras here.
Speed cameras would be nice because eventually people would learn they're there and they would slow down.
But some motorists have found a way around the mechanical cops.
I'm dead set against having technology control human behavior.
Steve Farage, a Maryland software salesman, spends anywhere from 5 to 12 hours a day working out of his Cadillac. And he's got information most other drivers don't. The location of every speed and red light camera in the U.S. is literally at his fingertips.
And there they are.
Where are they?
Up there. Right up there.
Farage installed a new program called Phantom Alert into his GPS.
It has an alert.
That's a 300-foot warning. I work a lot in the car, and so, you know, I need to have that in there to help refocus in case I'm, you know, the speed limit drops from like 45 to 30 like that, and if you're engaged in a call or something.
We rode along with Farage to see if it works. We tested it in a speed camera zone on Democracy Boulevard in Montgomery County. Farage programmed the Phantom Alert to first sound an alarm within 500 feet of a speed or red light camera.
It has an alert.
When he gets within 300 feet, the device issues another warning.
It has an alert.
Phantom Alert collects speed and red light camera locations from police websites. Subscribers also supply camera locations as well as where police mobile units are parked. Farage says Phantom Alert is only as good as the information that's put into it.
It's not 100%, but it's better than, you know, running naked, you know, so gives you a fighting chance.
By avoiding tickets, Farage believes the device has already paid for itself. They're not illegal in Maryland, but what do police think about them?
Personally, I don't think that's a bad idea.
Harford County Sheriff Jesse Bain is interested in speed cameras, but he says the county doesn't have the money to purchase the equipment. Bain says he's not opposed to drivers using devices like Phantom Alert if it makes them slow down.
Which is what the speed camera wanted to do to begin with, get them to slow down.
The makers of Phantom Alert predict Maryland's new speed camera law will be good for business. The cameras will be allowed statewide October 1st. And if you're caught, a ticket will cost you $40. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm David Collins.
By the way, Joe Sigmund hopes the county will come up with the money to install a speed camera along his road. And if drivers want to use devices like the Phantom Alert, he says he's all for anything that will slow them down. A one-year subscription to that Phantom Alert is about $40, the cost of one ticket.